This video is sponsored by Brilliant. So I first became curious about the power of our voices maybe a few months ago when I read about Margaret Thatcher lowering her voice over decades.
I'm very much aware of the responsibilities.
Very deeply.
Also, the Queen has altered her voice, and more recently, you may have seen some stuff about Elizabeth Holmes potentially lowering the pitch of her voice too.
This is what happens when you work to change things.
So I started to wonder, ladies, why are we lowering our voices? The way you speak is part genetic, like how long your neck is, and part learned, like a Valley Girl voice.
Whatever.
Or vocal fry.
Whole situation.
So no one sounds quite like you. Your voice and all of its qualities are as unique as your face. You know, your intensity, the loudness and softness of your voice, your pitch, tone, and nasality. This all seems relatively straightforward, but things get weird when we start making judgments about other people based on their voice. One voice expert, Professor Carolyn McGettigan, writes that in vocal communication, we adopt a variety of selves. And after I highlighted this, I spoke with her and she said,
I can adjust my pitch, I can adjust my intonation. If I had chosen to, when I moved to mainland UK, I could have started to speak with an English accent to try and fit in a bit more, you know.
So depending on what self people want to portray.
When you hear a voice, you're always hearing that combination of the physiology of that person and the way they use the instrument of the voice.
And the way people use the instrument of their voice can have pretty big implications. The 2012 election for the House of Representatives in the US is particularly noteworthy, as researchers in South Florida analysed the voices of almost 800 candidates running for almost every seat. They wanted to know if one feature of the candidates' voices influenced election outcomes, namely their pitch. Pitch.
Pitch.
Now, a lot of judgments that we make about other people are based on pitch. You know, the relative highness or lowness of your voice. It's worth noting that men speak, on average, an octave lower than women. So, that experiment I mentioned found that both male and female candidates with lower pitched voices were more likely to win elected office. Yep. In a separate study, people preferred lower-pitched voices of past US presidents and rated those speakers as having greater integrity and physical prowess. This seems to suggest that pitch affects your popularity, but does it affect how competent you are, how good you are at your job? Can you actually gauge that from a voice? Now, in animals, vocal sounds signal their size and ability to defend themselves, which does indicate competence and strength, if you're a deer. Yet in the human world, we still rate men with lower pitched voices as more attractive. And across gender, we're more likely to elect officials with deeper voices. So the researchers followed up by collecting samples of the voices of members of Congress. And they also collected this thing called their power ranking. Basically, it's a score of how effective they are at politics. They analyzed voice pitch and mapped it to this power ranking and... no, nothing. Vocal pitch doesn't have any relationship with leadership ability. Yet, researchers in South Australia have found that the average pitch of women's voices has dropped by 23 hertz over the past 50 years. Like here to here.
Here and there.
And they speculated that over time, women have adopted a deeper tone to project authority and dominance in the workplace. In addition to Australia, the pitch of women's voices over the past 50 years has also lowered in the US and Canada and Sweden, which is a lot of people in a lot of countries, and I actually just realised that I'm one of those people. It blows my mind that lower pitched voices not only affect who we vote for, but it's also led to women all around the world lowering the pitch of their voices over generations because we think people sound more competent and authoritarian when they have lower pitched voices. Isn't that crazy? So the next time you're listening to a speech or an interview or a presentation at work, analyze the words, because the pitch isn't always perfect. Now, brilliant.org is a platform where you can keep learning through problem solving. They're the sponsor of today's video, and they publish daily problems that provide a quick and fun view into logic, math, science, engineering, or computer science. You can calculate the area of a snowflake, for example. And if you want to learn more, they have a lot of courses that explore concepts in more detail. So to keep learning every day, head over to brilliant.org/BrainCraft. That lets them know that you came from this channel. You can sign up for free, but the first 200 people that head over there are also eligible for 20% off an annual premium subscription. And thank you to my top tier patrons. I'm going to do this from memory. Patrick Olsen, the Patreon associate producer, Jason Schoenenberg, and Jack Tabor. Thanks. See you next time. See you next time. Sound like Schwarzenegger now.